Okay, so what we're going to do is we're going to get famous Jews to go back to their original Jewish names and repatriate themselves back into the Jewish people. It's time, okay? Don't you think? All right, I'm starting with Joan Rivers. We just needed to ask Joan a quick question about her original name, Joan Malinsky. We're a Jewish show.
I don't think she's available at all, unfortunately.
I'm about to call Piper Laurie. I'd love to do a very short interview about Jewish names with you. Piper Laurie hasn't called back. Jason Alexander hasn't called back. Larry King could be at Nate Nell's. That's our first stop. So we're here at Nate Nell's. Larry King supposedly has breakfast every morning here. Larry King changed his name. So we're gonna try to get Larry to change it back. It's time. So, looking for Larry King. we're looking around here and looking for some Jews, okay? I don't see Larry King. I guess now we're gonna have to eat.
This is the first time our interns have ever had pastrami. Let's see what Diana's reaction is.
I'm doing a thing on Jewish names, right? Larry King, he's here a lot. So what do you think about him changing his name from Lawrence Zeiger? Do you think he should go back to his real Jewish name?
No.
Larry King, is he going to come in here?
Not at this moment. Sometimes he frequents the bagel restaurant down on Beverly.
Okay, here we are at Brooklyn Bagel in Beverly Hills, Larry King's second favorite Jewish hangout. And let's hope he's there because, you know, we gotta get him to change his name. Come to think of it, you gotta figure this must be a pretty good bagel place if Larry King does eat in here. He's from Brooklyn and he's a Jew. Larry King was here 20 minutes ago. We just missed him. Why? Because we went into a deli and we couldn't resist the food and we had to eat and we missed him. If we had just left Nate Nell's, we'd have been here. I can't find him. Just slightly behind wherever he goes.
Oh, so good.
Oh, kidding me? That's a bagel. This is a serious bagel. I can't find Larry King. I can't get Joan Rivers. I don't know where Jackie Mason is. So we've come to Hollywood Boulevard. I'm gonna pick up one of those mats at the Stars Homes. Let's see what happens.
How much are they?
$7.
$7? Where are they?
Inside.
Come on. How up to date? Wait. What are you doing? Like a crack deal here? What's going on?
Oh yeah. Crack, heroin, whatever you need. Come on.
I'm a little nervous here.
Might have some hookers in there too.
I'm looking for where Jewish celebrities might live. Do you have anything?
Let's check the names there.
Yeah, what do you got?
Ben Stein.
Ben Stein, yeah, it's a little too sounding Jewish. I'm looking
at Larry King.
Larry King, are you kidding me?
No.
Larry King's house?
Oh my God, I mean, come on, man. What were the odds that Larry King would be on the map of the Stars Homes? I guess pretty good.
Let me see what the addresses are. Where is it again? Larry King.
I'm buying a used map of the Stars Homes. It's actually used.
Oh, yeah.
I'm paying $7 for this.
Oh. So you're really going to go and ask them to change their names back? So a lot of these people have other names and they've changed.
Yeah, Mel Brooks was Melvin Kaminsky.
Oh, but it sounds too Jewish.
Yeah, but we're in the day and age who cares about that, right?
Yeah, we're getting a little bit more quality these days.
It's only a little bit?
No, yeah, we're getting there.
We're there, right? I mean, I think Melvin Kaminsky can get work today. You think?
Yeah, sure.
Yeah, Joan Malinsky.
Who's that?
Joan Rivers.
Oh, nice.
We've just pulled up in front of Larry King's home, and I'm scoping the house out. I'm not gonna kid you, I feel like a stalker, okay? There's laws against this. But I think I have to do this because this is the
denouement
of the piece.
You know, I hate when people stalk other people. You know, people deserve their privacy. And I'm sure Larry deserves his, you know. But sometimes these causes are just too important. Do I press the button? Are you legally allowed to press the button? Yeah, but what is he going to do? He's going to call the police. I'm overcome with the fact that I feel like I'm intruding on his life. You know, there's one thing catching a guy in front of a bagel store or a Jewish deli, but when you get to his house, I know we're on public property, but I don't know, there's something... I mean, I guess it couldn't hurt to ring the bell, right? I mean, he just pulled up and...
Larry, can I ask one question? Just one question. Quick question. Scott Rubin with Chutzpah from JLTV. I have one. It's a Jewish network.
Yes.
We have one question. Just a quick question we're asking Jewish celebrities. It's totally innocent. I swear to you, it's totally. I'm with a new show called Chutzpah on JLTV. And we tried to ask you a question at the bagel place and this, but we kept missing it.
So it's a show we do. It's called Chutzpah. It just started airing. I'm the host, writer. I'm a former editor of National Lampoon for 10 years. And, all right. Well, the question is, right, there's certain, you know, Jewish people that changed their name years ago because they had trouble working and so forth like that. But we're in the day and age where everything goes.
I was given my name by the director of the radio station where I started. And he said you couldn't use Zeiger. Now they would. But I changed it.
So but would you ever consider, because wouldn't it be cool if, like, Joan went to Joe Malinsky and you went to...
They were too much of a departure. My name was Kingova or something. But to go from King to Zeiger, no one would know me. I mean, that would be...
No, but it would get pressed that you went back to your original Jewish name. It would be a big thing that we're repatriating ourselves back to our Jewish roots. I mean,
Think about it. I hadn't thought about it. I mean, my name is so embedded, like, all over the world.
I know, but that's even more reason to do it, because it's a statement. You went back to your heritage, because now it's okay. Look, gays are out of the closet. Everybody's out of the closet.
I'm not in the closet.
I know. They put you there. Some guy said...
But I always tell my name and stories about me.
No, I know. But now to be Larry Zeiger. I mean,
all right, let me think about it. All right.
Come back.
Yeah, I will. I mean, it's interesting. I don't know. Let me talk.
Right. Thank you, Larry. Just right. Consider. Really appreciate it.
I'm always a Zeiger.
All right. God bless. I can't believe it. I'm kind of humbled, you know. Larry King, we got to talk to him, and he was great. He actually is going to consider it. If you got a Jewish name and it's not so horrible, go back to it. That's all we're saying. And now Larry King's thinking about it. Larry Zeiger. The Larry Zeiger special. Yeah, I'm watching.